A word to the Christian artist. I wanted to speak to you today about your calling as an artist. This includes those that identify as a Christian artist and those who identify as a Christian who is an artist. Regardless of whatever title you go by, it is important for me to share this pressing word with you. First is that you have been truly blessed by God with your abilities to write lyrics, skillfully play instruments, and either sing, recite, or rap words that will speak to the hearts of people. However, what you must also understand is that as an artist, you are a minister of the gospel first in the form of your art. Therefore, it is critical for you to understand that you, just like other ministers of the gospel, are held accountable for what you speak in your art. Whether you may realize it or not, your work makes an impact on those who listen to you. Therefore, it is important that you do diligence when it comes to sharing your art, to making sure that your lyrics align with scripture and point people to Christ. If you want to know what that looks like, all you have to do is go to the book of Psalms. In Psalms 100, it states, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations." In this psalm, we can learn a few things. First is that there is a call to worship God. There is the call to serve God, to know God. And it goes on to talk about who God is and gives thanks to him for all that he has done. Although every artist is unique in their expressions of art, a clear distinction must be made between your lyrics and those of this world. And although the world focuses on entertaining people and feeding their flesh, as a Christian artist or minister of the gospel, your purpose, your talents, and gifts are to redirect people back to God and away from the cares of this world. Now, this does not mean you cannot share your own personal stories of heartache, struggles, observations, and triumphs. However, if you leave God out of your art and his word, then brothers and sisters, you have made your music about yourself. In scripture, David did talk about his many trials or issues that were happening during his day. However, he would also mention God and how the Lord is his salvation. You see, he would always redirect himself back to God. And as Christian artists, it is important that you do the same. Do not let the enemy deceive you like he does to many in the world, to get you to focus on streams, views, likes, or followers. Do not let him tempt you through fame or earthly possessions or riches. Do not let him infiltrate your thinking by adopting the ideas and wisdom of this world to be successful. For the ways of the world are not of God, but from Satan. We are living in the last days, brothers and sisters, and in these last days, what Christians and the world need to hear is more messages of the saving power of Jesus. They need to know that Jesus is the answer for everything they are going through. They need to know that with everything that is going on in this world, that Jesus loves them, that he died for them, and that he wants them to have eternal life through him. Your lyrics are in vain if God is not at the center of them. Your lyrics will be no different from the world's if you only focus on problems and don't offer people the solution. What good will come from your art if you only discuss relationships, racial injustice, personal struggles, current events, and so forth? If talking about these issues won't save people from hell. Whether you want to avoid this topic or not, hell is real. As a minister of the gospel, when you write or work on your craft, this is a reality that you must keep in the forefront of your mind and art. So, you got a great beat. You got a great hook. Your vocals are on point. You're spitting those bars. But are your lyrics and beat feeding the flesh or feeding the spirit? Are they glorifying God, glorifying you, or are they glorifying the world? So you say, I talk about life. But are you redirecting people to Christ, or are you directing them to the world? The choice is yours, but count the cost. Remember, although you are a Christian artist, you still are ministers of the gospel. And know that you are accountable to God for not only how you use your gifts for Him, but for what you say through your art. Think about it. God bless.